John here, guys. I'm out flying drones in the field, getting used to some new tuning that I've done, practicing in an open space so that I don't destroy this. This is one of my backup quads, and I wanted to give you 5 flying tips so that you can fly better and fly safer. These are gonna be quality of life tips. So number one, always, and I'm talking about always, record DVR. It doesn't matter if you're doing a quick test flight or whatever. I'm not in the habit of doing that. I'm only in the habit of recording on race laps or something where I'm testing for the channel, and it bit me yesterday. I crashed practicing, landed on the roof of somewhere, and I didn't record the DVR, and it took me forever to figure out where that quad actually was. I managed to save it, but so always record DVR. I have these Fat Sharks set to automatically start recording as soon as they're plugged in. That's a nice feature, or you can do it manually, but always record DVR. Tip number two, when you're plugging in your battery, first, you want to strap it on really good. It doesn't matter if it's a racing style battery on the bottom or a freestyle on the top. Next thing you want to do as I'm plugging it in, notice where my hands are. I'm actually going to hold it like this so that the props are not facing me or facing my fingers. See right here, there is no chance of me getting bit. I can plug it in. Then as I walk to go place my quad, I'm holding it by the bottom with the props facing away from me. Next up, if you're carrying your radio, I have a habit, racers, we carry our quads to the race line, put them down. I usually have my radio with me and I usually have it powered on. Sometimes because I want to test to make sure that it arms on the line before I go back and sit down. In case there's a problem, I may have to get a backup quad. As you're doing that, some of you guys have a dual arm feature on there. That means you have to engage 2 switches in order to do that. Now, if you haven't set that up on your radio, here's another tip for you. Betaflight will not typically arm unless your throttle stick is all the way down. So if you're walking to the line, make sure your throttle stick is in the middle. So if you accidentally bump your arm switch, it's not gonna arm like this because your throttle is in the middle. Don't put your throttle all the way back down until you get to your seat, till you put your goggles on, then do it, then arm. That is just one way to have a safety feature without that dual arm. Number three, always inspect your quad before you go and put it. Now, I'm not talking about you gotta take it apart and look over every solder connection, but make sure the props are on stable. Give it a little wiggle like this, make sure none of these arms are delaminated or cracked. You want to physically inspect to make sure your lens is not loose, to make sure your lens has not got bumped up or down. So give it a quick once over.
Just give it a good once over.
You want to be able to develop an internal mental note of how to check over everything in your quad in about 10 seconds. So arms, props on tight, prop condition, camera angle, ready to go. Next up, this is just a quick tip. Always triple check everything that you're gonna bring. So whenever I pack up, it takes me forever. I gotta charge pack, I gotta bring spare props, I gotta bring spare arms, I gotta bring spare everything. Remember and check. I've gotten to the flight field a few times and left my radio sitting on the bench. Just give everything a once over before you actually leave the house. Last but not least, remember to have fun, guys. This is a fun hobby. This is what you want to be doing with your weekends. As soon as you decide that FPV is for you, I fully recommend to build or buy as many backup quads as you want. After a while, by the time you pack up, by the time you charge up, by the time you travel to the field, you will start to notice that the most valuable commodity is not money. It is the time to fly. So don't risk your hours and hours of preparation, your hours of travel, and when you have a full day to go fly, finally your wife's off doing hot yoga or some other girly thing, to have only one quad with you, and when you break an arm or something, you don't have a spare, you're done, and you got to do that long drive home of shame. You were doing another drive home of shame in your 20s, but now that you're a little older and you're worried more about drones than girls, that's the drive of shame that you have to worry about. So bring spares, bring enough to where you can just whip out another one and keep flying. If you only have micros available, bring those, because at least if you crash all your 5-inch, you can still get a little bit of stick time, a little bit of flight time. Now here is a bonus tip. Always have your quad ready to go. Once you go pick it up, immediately the first thing you want to do is unplug the battery. In fact, I would unplug the battery before you even pick it up. Make sure it's on the ground, make sure the prop's not gonna bite you, take the battery up, then pick it up, walk back to your seat. As soon as you get back, do your quick inspection, replace any props if necessary, but before you even do that, take off your battery, put it with the other used ones, take a fresh battery, put it on, strap it in, and now you're ready to go. Don't plug it in. Don't plug in on people. Get in the habit of doing this, whether you're flying by yourself or flying with other people. You always want to have your quad ready to go. If you are flying with other people, yes, it's exciting to be flying with people that actually enjoy the same hobby as you do. So you want to socialize and chat a little bit, but make sure your quad is ready to go, because if it's your turn to go up and freestyle, if it's your turn to get to the line, you don't want everyone to have to be waiting on you. Oh my gosh, I didn't have a battery on. I gotta put fresh props on. I gotta do this, I gotta do that. It's a constant problem when flying with other people, and we always wanna fly with you guys, but please get your quad ready. That will serve you for the most flight time, the most packs per flight session imaginable. Bonus tip number two, if your quad takes a little bit of a tumble, just bring it back to yourself. Take a quick look at it. Make sure you don't have a prop going like that. It'll save you a lot of trouble in the long run. I know the temptation is to just, if it can arm right away, go ahead and send it for the rest of the pack. But check it out. Make sure your battery's not hanging. Make sure there's not a wire about to come off. Make sure that the prop is not damaged. That is the number one way a lot of us smoke motors is trying to, instead of just bring it straight back to fix whatever's wrong, if it can arm, go ahead and send it. Don't do that, guys. What do you guys think in the comments? Do you like these type of videos out in the field? Just a quick little quick tips while I'm out flying for you. This is my new on-the-go camera that I'm testing, so let me know if the audio is good. It is the onboard mic right here. Of course, there's a lot of cicadas out here. It's hot in Texas, so I'm gonna get back in the car and fly from there, and here's a little bit of the practice footage I've been doing today. Thanks, guys. Case in point. So case in point, check out this prop. If I would have turtle motored on the concrete, I probably would have scratched up some more props. I might have been able to limp this way back up or even keep flying, but this would have smoked this motor. There's a good chance it's already a little bit warm. So by me going to check it out, instead of sending it more, yes, I had to walk 50 feet, but wait, that's exercise, guys. We all need a little bit of exercise. This is why I'm still able to fly this quad that I flew all last season for this season as a backup. Notice the other thing, I'm not flying my main quad on this concrete practice session. This is my backup. It's a quad I built last year. And the reason that all of these expensive motors are still going is because I don't send it in situations like this. Perfect case in point. Go pick it up, guys. Just pick it up.